This is the U7 Pro Outdoor, a more robust and 6 GHz version of the U7 Outdoor that I reviewed back in September. On the U7 Outdoor, I was blown away by the results, getting Wi-Fi up to 800 feet away. Today, I have a more challenging and industrial environment for the U7 Pro Outdoor to see how it can fare and how far it can send Wi-Fi through this parking lot, which is full of a concrete barrier in front of me, as well as solar panels and cars behind me. I'm back at one of my clients, the Long Beach Beer Lab, where they regularly host festivals in the parking lot throughout the year. During that time, they need solid Wi-Fi for payment terminals, as well as any of the broadcasting that they're doing, or for guests to access the Wi-Fi on their phones. They recently mentioned the challenge of bringing Wi-Fi out with an extra indoor-rated nano access point that they had, and I told them that they needed to get one of the U7 Outdoor products. Ubiquiti was kind enough to send this over so that I could test it out, and let's see how it does in a real-world environment. Some details on the U7 Pro Outdoor is that, similar to the U7 Outdoor, it does have a front-facing, checks notes, integrated super antenna, or sector antenna, for the more traditional networking folks in the audience. But this adds in a more robust IP67 weatherproof rating and a full 6 GHz radio. Similar to its younger sibling, it still has the antenna ports on the top that are in fact upgraded and more robust, but do not change the direction, as I'm showing off on my B-roll over here. Do not change direction and point in the different areas, but they are omnidirectional antennas if you wanted to not use the front-facing antenna and have Wi-Fi 360 degrees around the unit. For today's use case, though, we are going to be blasting Wi-Fi all around me to cover this entire area for when they do festivals and different setups here in the parking lot. Let's plug this thing in, get it adopted, and see how it performs. I'm now standing in the position of where we're going to be mounting the U7 Pro Outdoor. We're going to be putting it up on one of these poles over here and pointing it in the direction of the parking lot over there. Now, you'll notice the concrete structure that they have here protecting some equipment that they have. That's going to be challenge number one, to see how well the signal is going to be able to penetrate that and continue to serve the rest of the area. Challenge number two is going to be any of the cars that are in the area, as well as all of the metal structure from the solar panels. The distance here is approximately 300 feet from where we're going to have it mounted all the way to the end of the parking lot. So I'm going to get it set up in a temporary mounting situation, since I'm not allowed to leave this out in the wild until it's officially released, and we'll see how it performs. As I mentioned before, we're going to be mounting it to this pole temporarily just so that we can point it at the parking lot and do our test in the box. We have our mounting setups here, and I don't need the antennas because I am firing out of the front-facing sector antenna. Okay. Now, because it's an articulating mount, it doesn't really matter all that much where we put it. We are going to need the little screw that comes with it to go into the top up here so that it gets mounted properly through. And we're going to take this, slot that on like so. And again, this is temporary, so pay no attention to the quality of the wiring here. All right, good enough for government work. Now, you may notice that it is a little bit floppy. So in order to solve that, we're going to use the included Allen wrench. Fun fact, Allen wrench was named after the guy who invented it. His name was Allen. Tighten this up a little bit. Okay, and all right, now we have the direction set up. One last thing we forgot to do was adapt it to the controller. All right, we have the U7 Outdoor connected. Let's go into Wi-Fi Man. And it shows that we are now on the U7 Outdoor. Let's do a speed test. 800 meg down, excellent. Now remember, these guys don't have full 2 gig just like I do at home. So I'm actually gonna take this and do a similar test at home to test how far it'll work going down the street, which is coming next after I finish wrapping up my tests here. But that will be with my full 2 gig connection wired in, as opposed to this, which is only about 1 gig. So you can see here, we're getting, and they are on cable, so it's not synchronous. They're getting 788 meg down and 43 meg up. hit done here. We're gonna go signal strength, and you can see that I'm currently connected to the U7 outdoor. Signal strength is obviously excellent because I'm standing right in front of it. Throughput, we're looking at 800. Should be doing better than this, but I think it may be because some of the network settings. Also, it's not on a 2.5 gig connection. So anyway, let's take a look at the signal strength and start walking away down into the parking lot. Let's see how far it goes. We're now passing the concrete barrier that I mentioned before. Down to negative 74 decibels, which is good. And just lock this on my face so that, there we go. Now that's got active track enabled on here, which will be less nauseating for all of you, I think. All right, we are now 68 decibels away. We're about halfway through the parking lot here. You can see the concrete structure, and just beyond the concrete structure over there is, just beyond the concrete structure just behind my head, is where the access point is set up. Okay, so now we're going to continue onward from there. Oh, we just dropped to negative 76. We're now officially in the poor range. Let's keep going. Still connected. We're on 5 gigahertz at the moment, by the way. Not sure why we didn't get on 6 gigahertz. Maybe that dropped off. I'll have to rewatch the video and comment on that at the end of this test. Okay, interestingly enough, we're 3/4 of the way through the parking lot here, and that's pretty far away, and I'm showing a negative 80 decibels, and it only just dropped one signal bar on my iPhone here, so, which you can notice because I'm sharing the screen there, and you can see it went from 3 bars to 2, but the signal strength right now is significantly degraded than where it was because we are pretty far away, and there's a lot of stuff in the way, cars, as you can see, and all of the metal structure here. That being said, if we go over to the speed test, standing right here, I'm still getting 200, 250, 270. This is fantastic. This is more than usable. Even though the metrics show that it's a poor signal, this is completely a usable Wi-Fi signal all the way out 3/4 of the way through the parking lot. All right, let's go back to that signal screen here, and let's keep going. Walking all the way to the back wall. And then we're gonna go over there, and that'll be the far corner of the parking lot. Still connected, still cooking. Okay, now I'm gonna turn off active track so that you can actually see behind me. No, disable active track. Now you can see the whole parking lot area here. And that building, if you notice, that's the building where we mounted it all the way out there. So this is now about 300 feet away. And on my phone here, I'm still at negative 83 decibels, but let's go to the speed test. And once again, still getting 100 meg, it's tanking. Oh, it's climbing again, 100 meg, 130, 140, 150, 160. Upload, remember the max upload on here is only about 40, give or take. So now we're at 25, 23, still more than respectable. I don't know why we're getting a higher physical upload speed than we are download speed, but I guess I'll have to ask Ubiquiti about that. All right, let's put active track back on me and let's go all the way over here, put even more cars and metal and structures and whatnot in between us and the access point. I have zero expectation that this is going to work, but let's see. I hope nobody steals my drill over there. Okay, we're gonna hit done on that, and let's see, where are we here? Again, negative, we're back up to negative 74. It's like we're closer now. I can actually even see the top. Oh, my wife is calling me. Sorry about that, my wife called in the middle of my test over there, so the screen recording stopped. And I just talked to her. All right, so let's do a quick speed test standing over here. You can see how far away I am. The office is all the way over there. I'm getting better speeds here. I'm getting 200 meg down. This is fantastic. Upload also, 50, 60. I'm getting better speeds here than I am straight away. I guess it makes sense because this is a direct shot line of sight, whereas that's not. I'm gonna go over there, which I'll show you is the street. And we will see how far this goes, just for, you know, funsies. Hello. Signal's kind of all over the place, but it's working. Let's go for a little walk. Going through the trees. I'm gonna have to look up on Google Maps later to see how far this is, because it seems like it's pretty far. Oh, it's gone. We lost it. That tracks, given that there was a house in the way. Let's see if we can, where we recapture it. There it is. Okay. So again, far corner of the parking lot. Let's turn around here so that you can see. This is the concrete barrier I'm on the other side of, and that's all the way to the end of the parking lot over there. And we're at minus 84, and I'm gonna do a quick speed test. Okay, it's starting to lose it. That makes sense, 60, 70 meg down, but that is still very usable, even all the way out here. Now, just to show how usable that is, I'm gonna go over to YouTube and load up a video, and let's see how well it plays. In case it was cached, let's move through to the middle. Okay, so now you can see it's buffering. It's working on it. It's not wonderful, but hey, that's pretty good at, what's the quality that we have on this set? 2160, that's 2K quality. Sorry, that's 4K quality. All right, 2160 is 4K quality. And so it took a little bit, it took a minute, not even a minute, it took a few seconds to buffer the full 4K quality of the video, but it is streaming it without a problem all the way over here. So it's definitely usable completely 350 feet away from the access point. All right, now let's go make sure nobody stole my tools. All right, made it all the way back. Now it's time to take the setup down for another day, test complete. And I look forward to rolling these out in the wild and mounting many more of these across different customers. The U7 Pro Outdoor costs $279 and is available today. Please leave your questions and comments down below. I do my best to see them and answer as many as I can. And as always, thanks for watching.